Hey there, I am Parth Doshi, exploring the field of RPA and sharing my learnings with you by making videos. So this is the next video in the playlist of data table activities. This video is going to be short, but we are going to see a very informative activity that we can use in our data table operations. So what we are going to do in this particular video, let me give you a quick overview of that. So many times we have a data table. You can say we have a data extracted from a website, or we have something else. We have data in our Excel file, but we don't want some specific columns from that, or we just want specific columns from that. So suppose there are 10 columns being extracted, we need only either two of them, or we need to remove two or three of them. So how we can do that using data table activity? So without any delay, let's get started. So first, what we are going to do is we are going to take a read range activity of workbook. Okay, so I think this is of Excel. Let me delete this. And read range we have of workbook. So let's go to the Excel file. We are going to take this particular Excel file. Let me also show you the Excel file. This we are going to remove, and the output of this Excel we are going to store in the data table, that is data table. So let's click OK. Now let me show you an Excel file and what operations we are going to perform on that. So this is our Excel file, which you can see over here. Okay, so this, let me delete this. Yes, okay. So you can see this is our Excel file. This is the EMI data of the customers that we are having over here. So what we are going to do from this particular data table, we are going to remove the location and the EMI remaining columns. So let's see how we can do that. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use another activity, that is filter data table. Now here in filter data table, you can see we have to pass the input data table, which is our data table. Output also I'm going to keep the same. I'm not changing it. And now you see here is to filter rows and here is to output columns. So in this video, we are going to see what is output columns. If you want to understand about filter rows, there is already a video in this playlist. So output columns, there are two options, keep or remove. So you can specify multiple column names over here. So whichever column names you specify and select the operation keep or remove, that operation will be performed. So what we want to remove is EMI. Okay. EMI remaining. And the other we want to remove is the location. So I want to remove these two, and I'm clicking on remove and just clicking on OK. So you see, it was a simple one activity we need to understand. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to use write range. Okay, so I'm going to remove this. I'm going to copy the data in the same Excel file. I will just create a new sheet. Let's change the sheet name to filtered data, and the data table we are going to pass is the one which we have filtered over here, the same one. So we have used output columns wherein we are removing two columns, EMI remaining and location. So let me open this, save. So now if we go to see what the output should be, is there should be a new sheet over here with filtered data, and there should be only product name, email, due, and the EMI amount. Let me save this and let's run the workflow to see whether we are going to get the desired output. Okay, so it is taking some time to run. No problem. Let's wait for it. Okay, so the execution has started. We have the slow step, so we will see what steps are being performed. Okay, we got the data table. Okay, yeah. So we have the wrong sheet name over here. So the sheet name is EMI. Save, run. So these are the small things we need to ensure when we are building our workflow. Let me open the Excel file. So you see we have filtered data. Okay, so one thing we forgot in right range to select add headers. So let me just close this and let's run it one more time. Add headers is to just to have the column name of our data tables also with us. So you can see over here. We only have customer name, the product, the email, the due, and the EMI amount. So we don't have with us is EMI remaining and the location. So this is how you can remove the unwanted columns from your workflow. Now, other thing what we can do in output columns, let's select keep. And here what we are going to keep is customer name. We are going to keep, yeah. So we are going to keep customer name and email. Email. And we are going to keep customer name. So I want just want these two columns and let's keep it in some other sheet. Let me save this. So this is how you can use the keep property of the filter data table. Save. Save. Run. So now we should have only two columns with us. Let's see the filter data two. So you can see over here. We have only two columns, and also you see the order is followed. Even though the customer name comes over here first, but in my this particular workflow, I had kept email first and then later customer name. So the same thing is followed over here. You see, the first there is email and then there is customer name. So there is also an ordering followed, like first come first serve, you can say, which is followed. So I hope this video was helpful to you to understand one more concept of data table activities, which we can use to remove the unwanted data from our Excel file or from our data tables. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't done that yet, and press the bell icon to stay updated to all the new videos I upload. Thank you.